just a quick behind the scenes look at the projection mapping effect that we did on this miniature mountain here. This mountain is about 3 feet by 2 feet in size. Behind the mountain is a video display playing fireworks and clouds that we shot to give a little more depth to the effect. Then over here is a live feed from the computer display that's running a 3D software package called 3ds Max along with a particle system that generates a slime called Tyflow. It's interactive and it's in real time right now, so you're able to actually look at your projection and affect and design how you want it to perform. This viewport here is showing the camera that's projecting to the projector. So there's an output going from this display here to the projector and it's landing on the mountain. We're able to apply a surface onto the mountain here so that we can see how the projector is reacting on the surfaces. So that's a very handy thing to have that capability. So how did we get this 3D mountain and this real mountain to react so accurately with the slime sliding down on it? Well, we made a 3D scan of the mountain so that we would have a digital model in order to apply the particle system onto the surface of the mountain, which results in something that looks pretty cool. It looks like it's flowing down, especially like right through here. You can see that here, this flow. So 3D scanning is a very useful tool for projection mapping if you want to project onto a small object or a large object or a house or a mountain. Now, color is also a very interesting challenge. You can spend a lot of time working on color, way too much time. The way the color is applied is you select your color palettes and you can just literally change the color on the fly here, as you can see. All these are animatable functions so that you can program animation to change it over time. And by the way, there's a really good free open source animation package called Blender out there. If you want to get into doing this type of stuff with your projector, it's free and easy to use. There's a lot of tutorials about it, so it will be something useful if you want to get into more fun projection mapping like this. We also have to make sure that we calibrate our 3D scan mountain to our projected mountain, and that's accomplished by applying various textures onto the surface of the mountain itself so that we can see its alignment. And again, this camera position is set to lock right in there. So if I grab a hold of the camera, which is right there, and there's our little spotlight, you can see that little spotlight moves around on the surface. You can see it right there. It's over there. It's part of our intro here. It's animation. So the camera right here, let me select this guy, got him, is feeding to the projector over here. So if I slide this camera, you can see what happens to the projection. It goes wonky, or it can go various bigger, smaller, whatever you want. So I'm gonna undo that and put the camera back where it was set, which is there, and undo that select. And we'll bring this mountain back here with that little spotlight on it. So now let's put this texture color back onto the mountain. In this case, we're using gray. And the reason for the gray is that it basically acts as a neutral density filter, so it changes the intensity of the light hitting the surface overall. If I adjust that brightness down to black, we're still getting a projection of the slime, but the mountain is now, what ambient light is coming through the projector is passing through the black. That's all there is. So if we bring that back up, we can adjust the brightness of the mountain. Can also do other things with the mountain, texturing different surfaces, different colors. You can tint it, shade it, whatever you want to do with it, just like we did with the slime, yellow. So that's pretty fun. Now, as for the particle system, that's the slime maker, which is right here. We're right now producing 60 particles per frame, and there's a variation, so it varies by 80%. We can reduce that or increase it depending on how we want to do it. We can also change the size of the particles, which makes the slime larger or smaller. If we turn this down or turn it up, turn it down, there's less. If we turn it up, there's going to be more. Turn it up to 80 or something like that. There we go. If you can go to hundreds, thousands, millions, just totally covers the mountain as you saw in some of the other ones that we did before. So collision detection. Since it's a 3D scan of the actual mountain, what's happening is that the slime is mathematically calculated through collision detection to avoid the surface, or to follow the surface, you could say. And that's why it sticks and contours to the surface so well. It's a very important part of getting that effect to really play out well, as I've said before. You can see here, there, and then over here in the projection, you know, it's right there in the scene, going off that little cliff edge of that piece of rock right there. Pretty cool. Speaking of rocks, rock and roll here. We have these rocks, which are particle rocks. So they are actually, again, doing collision detection and following the surface of the model and bouncing off of it and then traversing down. And since these are particles, we have a little bit different control over these particles here. We can adjust the amount. Right now there's 200 particles. We can turn them up or we can turn them down. We'll turn them down to 20. And now there's 20 rocks falling down the mountain. You can see, or we can turn them up to 200. And there'll be 200 that'll be flowing down the mountain now. So you can see that's pretty cool. So what happens here that's interesting is we're using just shades of gray to create this effect, which gives that pretty impressive illusion of the rocks looking dimensional, but yet they're picking up all the color off of the mountain's natural color, okay? So the way that happens, again, is with this color thing here, which is right there. So this is the color of the mountain, and this is the color of the rocks. If we change the color of the rocks, it will pick it up and move it into the rocks themselves. So you can see now they've shifted over. We can roll the hue. We can apply surfaces and textures to them and make them do all kinds of fun things. But what I want to explain to you here is that when you're using shades of gray, again, you're affecting the amount of light that's passing through the projector. So if we turn down the light that's on the surface of the mountain, or turn it up, there's now it's down, it becomes black. there's a little bit of highlighting there from the shading, so we put a specular lighting here that makes that little sparkle stuff. So that's kind of how that plays out. So you can adjust the density of those two, and then just, since we're projecting white light or gray shades of light through to the mountain, we're able to achieve this effect. Bring out the flashlight here. You can see there's the actual mountain. And then if I'm washing out my shadow with the flashlight, as you can see here. A bit over there, somewhere in there, there. So the rocks will disappear because they're being burned out too. So you're painting with light, basically. And you can adjust to your heart's desire with this stuff. I'm going to turn these rocks down, make them go black, or you just set the density just so that you're getting the right. So there's a light here that's creating shading. I'll turn on this shader here to high quality there. So you can see the dark shadows that are helping give dimensionality to the rocks, even though all we're really just seeing through the rocks onto the mountain itself. I'll drag this camera so you get a closer view. There's my shadow there. So you can see how interesting it is. Just using the luminance of the scene alone, there's no color involved here. The only color is passing through is the color of the actual rock itself. Pretty cool. There are infinite possibilities with projection mapping. We just wanted to give you a quick kind of overview of this. It's not very difficult to do. All you need is a projector and a computer with a little bit of compute power and a 3D software package, like I said before, like Blender, and a subject to shoot. Now, if you want to 3D scan your object and then project onto it, that really is the best of all worlds, because you can really create that interactive surface. So I hope you get a chance to try it out sometime. And thanks for watching Electric TV. Stay tuned for more fun stuff here on this channel.